Tinybird Code is an advanced CLI agent with deep ClickHouse knowledge that you can use to plan, build, deploy, and optimize real-time analytics projects built with Tinybird. Here's a quick demo of what it can do. First of all, Tinybird Code is really good at one-shotting end-to-end analytics projects, including finding ClickHouse table schemas, building valid and parameterized SQL queries, and deploying them as production API endpoints. Here's an example. I'm going to run Tinybird Code with the skip permissions flag, which we like to call YOLO mode. As with Quad Code and other agentic CLIs, this just means Tinybird Code won't ask for permission to proceed with each step. So let's give it a prompt. I'm going to ask it to create a system to store software logs and expose an API endpoint that can give me some error counts grouped by various attributes. So it's going to go off and think and then generate a plan, which includes steps for the resources it intends to build and any other tasks like generating mock data. Then it will start building, working its way through the dependency tree. So first it's going to create a data source schema to store my logs. And you can see without any additional context, it's done a pretty decent job of defining a schema to store some pretty standard logs data. Then it'll build that resource on Tinybird local to make sure that the syntax is valid. It'll do the exact same thing for the API endpoint, writing SQL, adding query parameters and filter logic before building, validating, and then creating the endpoint file. Now it's mocking some data for my logs. So I can see that it has generated rows and appended them to the logs data source in Tinybird local. And then when it's done, it's just going to give me a summary of everything it just did. So that's all happening in my local dev environment. Let's go ahead and deploy. So I'm going to ask it to deploy, generate some mock data in my production environment, and then actually test some of the various API routes. So it's going to go off and do that. First, it will validate the deployment. And once it checks out, it will start the deployment process. So it's now pushing these resources on my local machine to my production environment in the Tinybird cloud. Then it's going to generate that mock data as I requested and append it to the data source in the production environment. Finally, it's going to go get the OpenAPI spec for the endpoint it deployed and make a few requests, including some with various query parameters as defined in its SQL. Summarizes what it's done, and yeah, I have a live error counts API that if I were to start sending some logs to this table, would return those real-time error counts by service, environment, etc. Okay. That's a basic example, and it's a flow you might follow if you're building something new, prototyping, building an MVP, something like that. But the real magic of Tinybird Code isn't just in building toy projects. We built Tinybird Code to be able to solve really complex data engineering problems to help you manage your deployments in production, optimize them at scale, and iterate as needed. Let me show you an example with a more realistic project. So I have an active Tinybird deployment that uses Tinybird's open telemetry template, and it has several data sources for OTEL logs, traces, and metrics. And I've got about 10 million rows in aggregate across the various data sources in this project. And I am also actively ingesting into a couple of these data sources and actively making requests to some of the API endpoints. So the first thing I'm going to do is ask Tinybird Code to create a new endpoint for this project. So for example, I want an API that will give me some list of API routes with high error rates and details on their latest error messages. Notice here that I'm not using the skip permissions flag, so I'll be confirming Tinybird Code's work along the way. So as with before, it's going to give me a plan and it's going to show me the resource dependency for this new API endpoint, namely that it depends on and will be selecting from the OTEL logs data source that I already have in production. So I'm going to tell it to continue, and it will go ahead and write what is a relatively complex SQL query with several common table expressions, parameterized filters, a join, yada, yada. That's SQL I didn't have to write, so I'm happy about that. Now, I could confirm these, but I actually prefer when Tinybird pipes don't use one big fat SQL query. I like breaking them up into pipe nodes. So I'm going to ask Tinybird Code to prefer that approach. So then it will rewrite the SQL. And you can see that it has broken up all those CTEs into separate nodes. Great, let's build it. And look, didn't get the syntax right. Now in this case, it forgot the percent character, which is a token that you must add to the beginning of a SQL node in Tinybird if that node contains a query parameter definition. So this is a nice thing about Tinybird Code, is it will take that error message and autofix its mistake as any good agent should. Once it's done, it'll show me the diff and see that new character. So let's build. And we have another error. but it looks like it's referencing a column that doesn't exist. And the nice thing here is that Tinybird's error message actually recommends a fix based on the known table schema. So Tinybird Code will again take that error message and go and autofix it. So once it's done with that, I can see the diff and how it replaced that bad column name with the correct column name from that error message. And after we confirm that change, it will build, and this time it succeeded. So now we have a valid endpoint that builds, and Tinybird Code gives me this nice summary of what it created. Now, I'm going to trust the agent and go ahead and deploy this new API. So Tinybird Code will create a new deployment, and by the way, there's some other changes in this deployment in addition to the new endpoint I added. And we're just going to let Tinybird do its thing and promote that deployment, and we are deployed. Now, if I hop back into the Cloud Admin console, I can go see that new API endpoint in the project lineage, and there it is. All right, so we added a new API. That's a non-breaking change, and quite honestly, not something that I might need an agent for, but I didn't have to write some SQL. It eliminated some of the drudgery of building and deploying a new endpoint, and so that's work that I avoided by handing it off to the agent. But let's up the ante a little bit and ask Tinybird Code to optimize this project in production. Let me show you an example. So let's ask Tinybird Code to optimize an existing API endpoint called error rate by service. We want to optimize for scan size and latency metrics, and I'm going to specifically tell Tinybird Code to start with some baseline metrics from my request logs, and then implement an optimization, and then test the optimized API to see how much we were able to improve things. So the first thing Tinybird Code will do is go and look at the last 7 days of requests made to that endpoint in the production environment. It's going to query the pipe stats service data source. And Tinybird Code will tell me that, hey, this endpoint is scanning excessive data. It's at about 200 milliseconds average latency, which isn't terrible, but it's not great either. And that's because this endpoint is scanning 40 megabytes of data for every request. And then when Tinybird Code goes and looks at the data that I have in that OTEL logs table, it realizes that, in fact, this endpoint is scanning the whole table, all 4 million plus rows. So then it gives an optimization plan. So in this case, it's recommending what I think is a pretty naive plan. It's simply saying we can apply a default time filter of 24 hours so that it will only get error stats from the last 24 hours. Now, this is based on what it has seen in that my production query patterns have always scanned the whole table and not filtered by time. I could always provide more guidance here, maybe ask it to pre-aggregate error counts in a materialized view or something like that. But for now, let's just implement its plan and watch it optimize. So it's going to go optimize that SQL and then show me the diff. We can see that it is filtering by a 24-hour period by default, unless a start time value is passed in the request. And it's also added this halving clause to remove any services that don't actually have any logs, which will make my API response lighter, which, to be honest, is a pretty thoughtful detail. So I'll confirm, it builds the endpoint, build is valid, and it asks me if I want to deploy. I say yes, because why not? And it's going to build this optimized endpoint. Now, if I were smart, I'd have maybe asked it to build some tests before making this optimization, and it can do that, and then run that test suite before deploying, but I'm feeling frisky, so we're deploying this right away, and if it breaks things, I'll let the front-end team figure it out. Now that it's deployed, it's going to test that new optimized endpoint with a request, analyze the performance stats, and then it's going to give me this nice, detailed optimization summary showing the performance comparison, key improvements, and a summary of how the optimization works. Pretty neat. But okay, that was another non-breaking change, at least for me. My front-end team might disagree, but at least for me, it was a non-breaking change. Let's crank up the heat a little bit more. First, let's see how many rows the OTEL traces data source has in production. Oh, by the way, you can ask Tinybird Code to query your data using natural language, and it will build and execute the SQL for you. So I can see that my traces data source has over 10 million rows, and if I probe a little further, I'll see that it also has active ingestion. Meaning, if I try to deploy a schema change, it's going to break ingestion and cause a bunch of downstream errors for any resource that depends on this OTEL traces data source. So let's get crazy and ask Tinybird Code to analyze the schema, optimize it based on my real production query patterns, and then actually deploy the migration. This is a complex problem that involves analyzing production request logs, using that information to update a table schema, deploying the updated schema, and then migrating all 10 million rows to the new schema without losing any data while streaming ingestion is actively occurring. Most humans can't do that quickly. Let's see if Tinybird Code can. So first, it's going to start querying the OTEL traces data source to understand the shape of its data. It's analyzing things like uniqueness, average values, etc. So it gets a pretty clear picture of the data that's in that data source. and it's going to give me an optimization plan based on what it found, which includes updating the sorting key, optimizing some column data types, and even selecting a better compression codec for low cardinality data. Now, it's planning to create a new data source with this optimized schema, but I don't want to do that. I want to change my OTel traces data source in place. So I'm going to go give it that feedback and see if it will update its plan. Great. I'm going to confirm that new plan to update the data source in place, and off it goes. And so here is that optimized table schema. We can see the changes it made, updated data types and improved compression for reduced storage, and also an updated sorting key to match my common query patterns, which are time series based and thus benefit from a time-based primary sorting key. I'll confirm this change. It'll build the new data source locally. The build is valid, and it gives me a summary and says, hey, we're ready to deploy. I'm going to go ahead and ask it to check that the deployment is valid. So it will go and determine if this new schema will work in my production environment, and it actually gets an error message from Tinybird saying, hey, with these new data types, your old column types need to be cast to new column types using a forward query. And Tinybird even provides its best guess at the forward query to solve the problem. So Tinybird Code says, oh yeah, you're right, I forgot to add a forward query for data migration, so off it goes to do that. Once again, shows me the diff with the forward query that it has added to the data source file. So it's going to build and then ask me if I want to check the deployment again. I'll say yes. And this time the deployment is valid because we have a forward query to map our old table schema to our new table schema when we migrate the data. All that's left to do is deploy. So I'll kick that off and let Tinybird run that deployment in the background and migrate those 10 million rows of data to my new schema without any data loss. So that's a pretty complex problem the Tinybird code just solved in relatively short time. If you're at all anxious about operating ClickHouse in production, Tinybird Code can help you with these kinds of difficult problems. Of course, as with all agentic experiences, it does require human oversight. That's where you come in. But it definitely removes a lot of the heavy lifting and helps guide these kinds of engineering solutions. Before we go, let me show you a couple of nice little features that Tinybird Code also offers. For example, I'm going to create a little dummy pipe here with a bunch of syntax errors in my local directory. When I open Tinybird Code, it's going to detect those problems and offer to fix them, and it will eventually get me to a valid build. So that's really nice. If you somehow leave your project in a broken state and come back to it, Tinybird Code can get you to a valid build quickly. You can also run all the TV CLI commands that come with the Tinybird Forward CLI directly in the agent session. You can perform natural language queries of your data sources, and you can even write direct SQL queries to query Tinybird local. Finally, you can add a Tinybird markdown file to provide any additional instructions to Tinybird Code. I already have a few in here, and for example, I could add one based on some of the earlier feedback I gave to use pipe nodes instead of CTEs, and Tinybird Code should respect that preference in future sessions for this project. Tinybird Code is a powerful CLI agent to help you plan, build, deploy, and optimize large-scale ClickHouse projects deployed in Tinybird. Thanks for sticking around for this demo. If you have any questions about Tinybird Code, you can check out the documentation, which is linked below, and you can reach out to us in our Slack community. I've provided a link to that as well. By the way, stay tuned for another video from us where we'll talk about using Tinybird Code as a sub-agent within multi-agent workflows. Tinybird Code works as a great sub-agent for CLI agents like Claude Code or Gemini CLI as a part of larger projects. You can instruct those agents to task Tinybird Code with any of your analytics backend work. Stay tuned. Cheers.